Hello everyone, I'm back, and this is part 3 of my big geode, large geode, and I'm going to place some more colors on the canvas. I'm starting with Snow White of Artie Sue, and it's going to be all around the green. I also turned my canvas around because when it is this way, I can easier work on it. So all the way around the white. And again, with my steering stick, I'm pushing the white against the green color. And the colors already on the canvas dried very nice. And I'm doing this very carefully because I want the lines as straight as possible. And I speeded the video a little bit, because otherwise it's going to be very long video. So carefully along the sides. So the first layer is all about laying the colors down, and the second layer is for me all about details, and also adding some more crystals, glitter, and defining some areas. Also around the chocolate gold of Lores, the white. And again, I'm using my steering stick. Next color is the Midnight Black. On the rest, in between the glitter gold and the green, and I will do it at the same way as I did with the other black. Also some Racy 10 Plus rich gold on top of it. So again, a line of rich gold. Again, some chocolate gold, because I want to balance the painting. So I want to have two parts with that color. And it's all about patience and not wanting to do too much in one go, because then you get rushed, and that's not good. also the sides, a little bit of heat for the air bubbles. And now I'm giving the Resi Tint Plus some heat to create the same effects as I have with the other black. Now I'm making a black line in the white at the edge, because I want to have some contrast. Now a little bit of heat, and now I'm trying to blow the black color over the white. But I need to watch out that I don't burn the resin. Also the other black line. Next is the fine glitter that I want to have around the black. Very sparkly. So I mixed a lot of glitter in the resin, and then it becomes thicker, and then it doesn't flow to the side that much. Very careful along the chocolate gold, because that's also wet, and I don't want it to flow too much in each other. So all around the black, I want this glitter line. Sorry for my friend's bulldog again, he is snoring a lot. Also there very carefully, because the white is also still wet. Again, another black line, because I want to have some more contrast. The last bit of my white on the canvas against the glitter line. Also some rich gold over the black, very thin line. And now again some heat. and you blow against the black and the gold, and then it will flow over the white. That's my goal. And it can blend a little bit in each other. Again, some black against the white, because I want those two to blend in each other, and also the glitter gold when I heat it. Heating it up, make it more liquid, and then blowing against the black to get it into the white and also into the glitter. Again some black to make a contrast with the white. Very carefully along the white, because it's still wet. Fixing the lines. Giving it some heat for the air bubbles. And now I'm poking with my stick through the glitter to get it into the black. So the last colors are going on the canvas, and again the midnight black. And at the moment it looks a little bit busy, but when I put the second layer on, then I'm trying to define the areas that I like, and also also some more crystals on it and glitter, and some special things I want to do with some colors over each other. I need to think about it. But I'm also already happy with what I have, because this is also a learning curve for me. I never did such a bit large geode. This is only my third one, so still learning. So I'm filling in the last two parts, both with midnight black. So again, carefully pushing the resin against the chocolate gold. Now I'm making a line between the two black parts because I like that better. So that they are connected. And now I'm putting some small opal crystals in between the crystals. Clear on top of it. Over the whole gold leaf area, it's going to be clear. Now some heat for the air bubbles. But also to make the clear a little bit more liquid, so that I can move it around a little bit easier. So I'm pushing the clear against the crushed glass. Last bit of clear on top of the gold leaf and the opal crystals. So this was step three of part three, and at the end of this video some close-up video. Then you can see how I've blended the glitter into the black and how it all dried. So what I told you in part 4 is all going to be about the details and adding some more crystals, glitters, defining some areas, and I don't know, maybe I need to do that also in steps, we will see. The last bit of heat. And the last thing I do is a little bit of fine gold glitter on top of the opal crystals to get it even more sparkly. So this was part 3, and now we are going to the close-up. This is after about 3 hours, and there you see the green and the last bit of white I did with the black lines in it. I'm very happy with it. Also the black and the white and the racy tint. So if you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. You can also find me on Facebook under the name Just Paint. And I will see you next time. Bye.